Flexbox, Flex, flexible box magic. It goes by many names, but whatever you call it, it's an extremely powerful layout property when it comes to creating common, responsive layouts, and it's become an industry standard across the web. The most important thing to note about using Flexbox, like most display properties, is that you set Flexbox on the parent element, the uppermost element, which then affects the children elements, the elements inside the parent element. We'll get into this and so much more in 5 parts. We'll talk about setting flex, we'll cover flex alignment, we'll show how children elements can override their parent elements, we'll show how to combine flexbox and auto margin to space elements in cards, and how to keep footers at the bottom of a page. Finally, we'll talk about how to wrap elements using flexbox. First part. Here we have a div block with a height of 100 VH, 100% of the viewport height. And from the add panel, let's add some elements inside our div. And as we're adding elements to our div, by default, they're all getting knocked to the top left of our div block. This is expected behavior. But now we have a heading, paragraph, and a button, which are children elements to the div block, the parent element. This all looks pretty basic, but we're here to add flexbox. And like we said a minute ago, you set flexbox on the parent element. So with our div block selected, we can just set it to flex. And the layout kind of is not that great right now, but we've unlocked our mighty flexbox controls. We can change our direction from horizontal to vertical, and we can even wrap our elements in many ways, but we'll get to that later on in our lesson. For now, let's move on to alignment, because once you set a direction for your layout, you can align and justify your children elements any way you want within the parent element. Here's another example, 3 cards within a section. If our goal is sort of a horizontal layout, then with the section selected, let's set it to flex. It's already horizontal, and center our children. But now the cards are kind of close, so we can either add space around the cards or we can add some gap between our flex children. By the way, some shortcuts for you. In Webflow, you can quickly add space between by holding down Command on Mac or Control on Windows, and then clicking anywhere in the Align box here. And you can also quickly stretch your flex children by holding down Option on Mac or Alt on Windows, and then clicking in again. Tons of control here, but it gets better. Let's move on to the control children elements have when they override their parent elements.
Just like real life.
Here's the same layout from before. We already have our section set to flex, but something to note is while each of these cards have the same class, they each have their own unique combo class, meaning changes to card ocean only affect elements with the card and the ocean classes applied. So, with this specific card selected, we have even more flex control in our style panel, and we can override the parent's alignment rules. We can even change the order of these. But keep in mind, even though we changed this specific card to be first on the canvas, in our navigator, which shows our document order, it's still last. That's because changing the order of elements using Flexbox does not change the document order, meaning screen readers like VoiceOver will follow the order of elements as shown in the navigator. But the takeaway is that flex children can override their flex parent. And remember, you need to use a different class or a combo class if we want to break the rules on only one flex child.
It looks kind of chaotic.
That's not how you say it.
Just like real life.
Are you reusing the same footage?
I'm being efficient.
Okay.
Just like real life.
Let's move on to the next part. Because once you've mastered Flexbox, you unlock even more layout techniques when you combine Flex with other layout controls, such as Auto Margin. And we'll cover 2 examples here. Our first example is kind of a pricing table. It's just pricing cards with fixed heights. And even though all of the cards are the same height, the design is uneven because the amount of content inside each of the cards are all different. So what is our goal? We want the cards to be the same height and have the last element stick to the bottom so it gives it a more symmetrical look. With our pricing card selected, let's set it to flex, the direction to vertical, and if we add space between the children elements, that will add space to all the content inside the card. So let's undo that and select the bottom element here. Also, quick note, these elements have the same class applied, so a change to one will affect all of them. But on this element, let's set the top margin to auto, and that pushes the last elements to the bottom of the pricing cards. Even if we change the height of the cards, it will always be pushed to the bottom. And here's how that works. When a parent is set to flex and all the children are stacked, in our case, vertically, setting the top margin to auto will create automatic space above that element to fill up any available space inside that parent. That's our first example of flexbox and auto margin. Second example is a page where there's a lot of space underneath. Now, you may want this, but if you want the footer to stick to the bottom of the page, we use the same concept as before. With the body element selected, we'll set it to flex and change the direction to vertical. And finally, on our footer section, we'll set the top margin to auto. And now the footer will always be at the bottom of the viewport, even though there's not that much content on the page. Last thing we're going to cover is flex wrap. And this is super useful for something like a tags layout for categories, where your flex children are different sizes. So here's something that resembles the start of our tags wrapper design. And currently, this div block with the class tag wrapper has a defined height of 300 pixels and is the parent element of our tags, the children elements. When we apply flexbox to the tags wrapper and set the direction to wrap, the tags now wrap to fit within the boundaries of the parent element. And we've unlocked even more control to align our tag elements however we want. If we change the spacing by adding the gap between the tags, they'll wrap perfectly when they hit the boundary of the tag wrapper. But there are multiple ways to wrap your elements. So just remember, when you use reverse directions, like right to left, they still do not affect the document order. So keep that in mind and use your wrapping powers wisely. Now, these are just the basic fundamentals of using Flexbox, and Webflow has ways to shortcut building and designing using these fundamentals, such as HFlex and VFlex, which are just divs already set to flex, and QuickStack, which is a grid with pre-populated divs already set to flex. We have specific lessons on these elements and so much more over at Webflow University, including when to use flex versus grid versus QuickStack. So definitely check those out if you haven't already. But in this lesson, we covered how you set flexbox to the parent element to affect the children elements. We talked about flex alignment controls. We showed how flex children can override their parents.
Just like real life.
We combined the powers of flexbox and auto margin to push elements to the bottom of their parent elements. And finally, we covered how to wrap multiple flex children within their flex parent. And that's an overview of flexbox in Webflow.